Hey Jackals, today I'll show you how you can display some data in DaVinci Resolve by using graphs, and we'll make this customizable. As you can see, I have here a fusion composition, and we'll make a fusion title that you can also increase the duration of it. Now let's get digital. We'll want to make a new fusion composition, right-click in the media pool, make a new fusion composition, and drag it onto the timeline. Then go into the Fusion page. And this is my whole Fusion composition, but let's take it one step at a time. So to make that, we'll want to use rectangle and the background. Connect rectangle to the background, display it on the left side. This side on the height. So we can make this 0.1. And this side on the final width. So in this case, my final width was 1.8. If you use 2, the bar will go all the way till the end. So in this case, maybe we'll go with 1.6. And to make this an animation and easily, what we'll want to do is position the center X position to 0. So this will be our final position, and how we could animate this is to animate the X position. But I found it easier to just adjust the width from 0 to 1.6. So we can do that. So let's say that the animation will start at frame 10. I'll do width 0, keyframe it, decide on the animation length. So this project is 24 frames, which means that is 1 second. So if you want this animation to be 1.5 seconds, we need 36 frames, so 46 frames in total, and this will be 1.6. So this is now the final position of this element. We can now adjust the Y position up and down, and we can also adjust the height if you don't want to have it that thick. So maybe 0.05. So we now have the base animation for one bar, but we need multiple of them. Now let's say that we want to add some text. The easiest one is to add the percentage. So use a text node. We'll display this like that. And in the text node, right click, hit expression, and inside this field, we'll put the expression. So the expression for the percentage is this one. I'll also link all of the expressions that I've used, so that we can just copy paste them inside, but you'll have to change the node names. So in this case, it's not rectangle 1, this one is rectangle 5, dot width, because we want to specify the width parameter, so I'll pin this one. How you can also do this, if you don't know which parameter is which, is to click on the plus sign while you have the rectangle pinned. Take the arrow, go down, and put it on the width parameter. And now it put in rectangle 5 dot width. And I'll divide this by my maximum width that I want, which is 1.6. And I multiply this by 100, so that I get full percentages. As you can see, now it's 88. If I don't have that, so now it's at 1%. So we multiply this by 100 and add the percentage at the end. But if you don't want that, you can also skip it, but I'll just leave it. So now it goes from 0 to 100. If you want to make adjustments when the text should be visible, you can make the adjustments in the merge node, adjust the blend. You could also do this in text in the shading tab by lowering the opacity. This is if you want to display percentages, but what we'll want to do in graphs, if you have some kind of performance numbers, you'll want to use the values. So let's make 2 text nodes, text 8 and text 9. You can also rename the nodes, just remember what you have for which node. And let's see, this one will be the main one, which will be this one, the top. I'll put here 9001. And the second one will be 2979. So we have the text like that. We can now quickly just adjust the position in the layout. like that. I'll just hide the percentage because I don't need it at the moment. So now we have two numbers and I need to make a second graph. So I'll make just a copy of these two nodes. How this will work is that we'll have this rectangle be the main one with the value that we input. So this could be anything and it will be always this long. And all of the other bars that we add afterwards will either be in descending or ascending order. So you can position this bar at the top or at the bottom. Or you can also have it mixed, like I have in this example. So now I've connected the second bar to the first one. And we need to now adjust the Y position. And we'll have to adjust the animation. Because now it goes all the way till 1.6. And for this we'll have to use some expressions. But before I do that, let's take a look how we can manipulate some text numbers. In here I have two numbers. This is the first one, it's an expression, and this is a text, as you can see, because it's text and it's in quotes. If I didn't use this and just use the number, this would not work. And this text node clones whatever this one has. So type here is the name of this text node, dot styled text, which is this text field, and we use value divided by 3, because I wanted to see if I can calculate anything from this, or if this is just text value. So if I remove the value, as you can see, the node is now red and this does not work. So if you want to calculate anything, you need to use value. And just so you can see that this actually works, I'll change the number here. And in here I have some examples how we can calculate using results of previous nodes. So this is text1 styled text.value, which is this one. And this one, as you can see, does not have text inside, it has an expression. And this node shows exactly the same as this one does. And the second node is an example where all the magic happens. We use a Lua script, a function of tonumber. It takes a string or a text and turns it into a number so that we can make some calculations on it. So we take the value of here, in this case 71%, take the whole string from the beginning until the last two characters. I've done -2 because I don't want to include the space and the percentage sign. If I didn't have anything, I could just remove the -2. And this all here is an expression that we save in a variable called a. This a can be anything that you want to be. So this could be main bar, if you wanted to have it like that, so you know what it is. And where you want to put that, you would also have to retype it. And in the end, we return that value so that we can display it. And in this case, I've done a test to see that if this actually works. Because it does display a number, but I wasn't sure if it actually is a number. So as you can see, it is. Because in this case, I've multiplied this value by 2. And if it doesn't update, you have to purge the cache. So it updates. And text6 was the last test that I've done on how to obtain the value of the rectangle. So now with the new knowledge equipped, let's make this work. So we'll be changing this rectangle, so we can maybe pin this one. Currently, as you can see, this is the same length as the first one and we want to change that. And how we'll do that is use an expression, as I said before. So in the width, type in equals. And now we'll have to make a custom length based on the first rectangle. So because we want to do that, we have to select the first rectangle. We will connect it to the width. So now we have the width connected, but it's the same as before. We want to make this so it stops somewhere like here, based on these two values. And then what we do is add this expression. In this case, it's text9, which is this value. Dot style text dot value divided by the first value, text.8, dot style text dot value. So you can leave it like that, but as you can see, we have a lot of decimals, and I've decided to round this to 2 decimals, and for that I've used the floor function, parentheses, went till the end, multiply this by 100, this rounds it down, and I've divided it by 100, and now instead of this value, we'll only get 2 decimals. And the last thing that I'll show you is how to connect the text to the actual graph so it moves alongside. So go to the text node, go to layout, in the center we'll type in equals, and we'll make a new point. If you make changes to the Y position, make sure that you also change it here. But you can't change it here, you have to change it inside the text field. So the Y position will be 0.5, but this one won't be. So because we're making changes based on rectangle 1 width, we'll do it like that. This is rectangle 5, that width, and we'll divide it by 2, which gives us the center position. So now as you can see, it's in the middle. To adjust that, we'll go back to the text and adjust the horizontal anchor to right. And you can also adjust this to the left if you want. And based on the adjustment that you made, you'll also then want to either do plus or minus. In this case, maybe it would be plus 0.02, just so you get some spacing, or minus 0.02, and adjust the alignment like that. And you have the animation. So this is how you can apply the numbers to the actual graph, but you can also use another rectangle if you want to display overclocking performance. In this example, I've done just that. I've used another rectangle and applied it on top of this one. It moves alongside it. And the only thing that I had to change was the negative value. This value had to be half of this rectangle's width, because you want to have it hidden like this. So if you don't hide it, it's going to be like that. And that's why I have to make it minus negative half of this value. And this is the process how I will add another rectangle and another text node and make it go down or up, just adjust the Y values on each graph. And then to finish this off, you'll want to save it as a fusion title so that you can use it in the ID page. We'll want to make a macro, and you'll want to do this in a way by selecting the text nodes first. So this one would be the first one, and so on, depending on the orientation that you have. So I would choose this one, then the second one, third one, and so on, and all of the other nodes at the end. But I wouldn't choose the media out. And then with all of the nodes selected, I would right click on the merge because it's the last node in the composition. Go to macro, create a macro. So this will be test bar graph. So we'll have text 8 and 9 at the top because that's how I selected them. I'll only enable the style text because that's the only value I want to change. And the same here. You can use other options if you want to change the style of the text, the color of the text, but I only want to change the value. When you have everything done, go to save as, but don't save it here as a macro. Go back to Fusion, Templates, Edit, Titles, and save it in the titles. So it's saved. Now the good thing now is that you don't actually have to restore DaVinci Resolve. It's already inside, as you can see. The only thing I need to do is use a solid, because this is a black background, just so we can see. And as you can see, we have now our graph, and we can extend it and apply it to whatever we want. You can also do this with other shapes, but I've shown you how you can do it like this. And this is how you can make a custom bar graph in DaVinci Resolve that you can display some data and have it at the tips of your finger by just dragging it onto the timeline. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell notification icon so don't miss my next video. And if you want to download today's tutorial files, you'll be able to do so by supporting me on my Buy Me a Coffee page. I'm Simon, and until next time, Jackals, keep it digital!